And Levin. You don't know.
I was told to join. Do I need to?
Yeah. Only if you want to. If you don't, if you.
I'm actually.
Thank you, Levin. It's very kind to come, but we. So you come in and you say, "I don't know." That's the strangest thing you've said today. You won your fourth game.
Yes. So far, so good.
So far, so good. Exactly. That was that. We knew we had to say that, but for the rest, we were preparing some questions, but we get to that later, or you want to have them now?
Okay, I mean, doesn't matter. I can show the game, or you can ask.
Yeah, well, let's say that both. I mean, what is happening? I mean, you're playing Levin Aronian, number two in the world, you're black, you're not supposed to win like this.
Well, actually, I cannot believe that my opponent played as bad as today, because normally he's much stronger player, and I mean, I lost to him many times. I know how strong he is, so I cannot explain. I mean, better to ask him.
Yeah, but he repeats the opening that you had in another game, and then the first 20 moves. I mean, he's looking for a fight in this opening.
Yes. He was looking for a fight, and actually, he told me that he mixed up some moves in the opening, and he wanted to play a little bit other move, not like he did, and then it was already completely unclear.
Yeah. So what is your secret, Sega?
No secret, I just come and play.
there is speculation about the lady you have with you. I mean, she works miracles.
Yeah, yeah. My girlfriend is...
Yeah.
Yes.
It helps, it works.
Sure.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe you should invite her, not me.
No. Now we're talking.
Yeah.
So, yeah, do you know where she is then?
Okay, actually.
Or you want to show the game first?
Actually, I think she's in the hotel.
Okay. Well, she will be following this, so
you
thank you.
You can say hello to her.
And thank her.
She's probably watching you, aren't you?
Yeah. Hello.
Now, maybe you should show us the game. And, well, the first moves can go quickly, because that's...
It was also my game against Hammer until here. And here in this position, Hammer played Queen d3, which is okay, just another move.
Well, were you surprised that Levin repeated this?
Well, I wasn't surprised because he played this line against me in Bilbao last year, and okay, I was more or less ready for this line. Okay, at least I was repeating it in the.
I mean, it was part of your preparation.
Yeah, it was part of my preparation, and but you know, there are so many moves for white that it's hard to remember all of them, and here already I didn't remember what I was going to play, but okay, rook c8 and f5 here looks not normal. For me, very natural, and here, of course, he should have played something like knight c6, bishop c6, knight c3, and okay, Levin thinks it is slightly better for white because of the bad pawn on f5. Okay, probably. I mean, the position is, I think, still very complicated. It's hard to say for me, is this better for white or not. But I mean, clearly it was much better than what he did. And after f3 knight d6, I think black is already fine because because my knight is going to c4 and yes, I take on e5 and all the tactic worked good for me. And now an important line after rook c1 knight c4 bishop f5, and here. Levin told me that he was afraid of move bishop g5. I don't know, actually, I didn't consider bishop g5. Maybe it's also good. But I was calculating g5 takes king h8. Now, now I think queen g6 is the best what I could find for white, and queen h5, king g7, bishop d3 if white is playing on win, and okay, here I can go king f8, queen f4, king e8, and the position is completely unclear. White has 3 pawns against piece, but white is not winning immediately, and it's really hard to say what is going on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I was expecting this, but maybe also bishop g5 here. Mm. Maybe also interesting. And after bishop c1, knight c4, I think f4 is a big mistake. He should have played, I don't know, anything but not f4. Maybe rook e1 was better. But I think black is completely fine with here. Maybe equal, I don't know. Mm. And after f4, b5, white is already fighting for a draw, because, he played knight c3, but I think this is a mistake. He should have played knight b2 and not to allow d4. Okay, at least after d4 he can play bishop g2, and white is holding the position. I don't know. And also it is important that after knight c5, which looks logical, I have takes on c5, takes, and d4. And now if he takes on f5, I think I can play rook f5, queen f5, queen d5, king f2, d3, and I think black is winning this position. I was calculating something like c6, check, but I think my king escapes from the checks here. King h5, and I'm winning. So that is why knight c5 doesn't work, and okay, once again, I think knight b2 was much more solid than what he did. Because after knight c3, the problem is that after check and d4, white can almost resign. Because, well, actually, I think the last critical moment was that he had to play knight a4 here to come back with a knight, and after queen c7, I think black is better because knight e5 is also a big threat, but it was still better.
Mm-hmm.
Better try. And after knight e4, after knight e2, which looks logical, rook d8, I mean, he basically doesn't have a move, because if he takes with the bishop on f5, then queen c6 wins, because I want to checkmate. And after king f1, knight e3, and if king e1, then I'm mating like this. And if he plays bishop e3, d3, and okay, queen e3, just rook d1 mate.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he cannot play bishop f5, and so if he plays bishop g2, also very important that I have bishop e4 here, takes d3, and I win here.
Did it make you nervous when you suddenly realized, whoops, there's number four coming?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't expect it, but okay. I mean, when I got my chance, of course, I had to use it. Queen f5, d3, queen e6, and here it is important position, because I cannot take. Because I could play a simple move king h8, and he has to take on b6, take knight c3, d2, bishop d2, and okay, I can also take this rook, doesn't really matter, knight d2, bishop g2, takes, then next is knight takes b5, and of course I'm much better in the endgame, but it doesn't look so clear for me, and I think white has a big draw in chances. And I was already searching for more than this, and that's why I played king f8. And here white could also do the same, like in this line, but with the king on f8, this is much better than with the king on h8, and here, okay.
And then you already had seen king e8 and those things.
Yes. Mm. So, but maybe still it was better for him.
Mm.
Because the problem is that after queen f5, king e8 is very strong, and the point is that e6 looks very natural here, but I have very strong reply. Rook d6, and if check, he takes here, I just take, queen e7, king b8, okay, doesn't matter, queen f8, rook d8, and next e1 is coming, and I win. It was very important line. I spent a lot of time to understand that after e6, rook d6, why doesn't have any move, basically, and but after Levon played queen takes h7, I could already take on e2, of course, but after queen h5, g6, queen takes e2, queen d4, bishop g2, of course this is much better for black, but still it didn't look so clear, and I thought, okay, maybe I have something more, and then I came up with a strong move d2, and after bishop d2, rook d2, white basically doesn't have a move, because if, for example, queen g8 check, bishop f8, e6, I can simply play knight d6, and white doesn't have any attack, and if he plays e7, I cannot take on e7, of course, because of mate, but I can just play rook d1, bishop f1, king takes e7, and I'm completely winning. So that is why he played e6 immediately, and after check, and take on e6. Well, basically this is clear that the game is actually over. And okay, here maybe it was a little bit better for him to play queen h8 check, and okay. I can even play queen g8, takes, knight c3, rook c1, and if knight takes b5, then bishop d8, I think, then bishop b6, and black is winning. But he played knight c3, and after queen c6, it's queen h5, king g8, and he can resign. And it's important that after rook f3, okay, I can also take on f3, I thought I can play rook f1 also. And knight e4, of course, doesn't change anything, I can just play rook. Okay, I mean, the position is completely winning, it doesn't matter.
Amazing. So when was the last time you started a tournament with four wins?
Maybe when I was 10 years old, I don't know.
So that's some time ago.
Yeah.
And how did you continue then? Fifth, you won the fifth as well, or?
I don't remember.
Simon, you have this look as if you have a good.
Well, we just had a look at the ranking list here. Now you're rushing up. How many places have you gained? Has he gained? But you're coming close to 2800 now.
Well, I think not really close, because still there are like 12 points or something.
Do you think about that? Does that play any role for you, the rating?
No, it doesn't really matter, because I'm playing a tournament here. Of course, after I started 4 out of 4, of course I want to, I want to fight for the first place. I want to score the first place, but still I understand that.
Anything can happen.
Yeah, anything can happen. And five rounds left, of course. I'm thinking only about the tournament, not about the rating.
Mm. But in general, is that part of your professional life as a chess player on this level, to take care of your rating? Or does it matter because you regained your reputation and everybody knows how strong you are anyway?
Yeah. Well, not normally, if I play well, then my rating is getting up. And if I play badly, then it's getting down. So I just want to play well, and I think the rating will come.
Mm.
Yeah. And the next game you will just approach like any other game.
Yes, like any other game. I will just I will just try to do my best and play chess.
Yeah. Okay, well...
I was just wondering if this was a chase after Magnus Carlsen, because there was so much talk about you and Magnus. You were approximately the same strength all the way, and you you both were talked about as being the crown prince. And now Magnus is a little bit above in rating, but now you suddenly started the chase after him. Doesn't work like that.
Well, we will see. I mean, I didn't play against him in this tournament. I'll play him tomorrow. I just want to show a good chess tomorrow, and I don't really care. Okay, of course I do care about the result, but I mean, I want to play chess.
Do you think that it was a crucial moment in your career when you switched federations and went to live in Russia? And
well, of course it was very important for me, because now I can work with a good coaches, and Russian Chess Federation helps me very much. Also, as my sponsor helps me very much. So I'm really happy that they have a big support in Russia.
Yeah. Because your sponsor, what kind of firm is that?
Okay, this is forex company.
And that's a sponsorship for several years, or how does that work?
Well, it depends very much on how good I will play.
So yeah.
So that's why I'm trying.
Okay, so it's your girlfriend and the sponsor.
Yes.
Okay, well, thanks a lot, Sergei. Yeah, there's a queue of players because three more games have finished. Mm-hmm. I'm sure we will continue our talk in the coming days. And so far, so good.
Yeah, so far, so good.
Thank you.